In this video, we are going to learn stationary stochastic process. So we are going to learn what is stationary stochastic process and why the concept of stationary is important for forecasting. So first the definition: a stochastic process is called stationary if its mean is constant over time, its variance is constant over time, and the covariance between two different time periods depends only on the distance. So these distances of 4 data points or 5 data points on that, rather than it depends on that you have measured it on between 4th and 10th or 14th and 20th. What matters is the distance. 4 to 10 is the time, 6 days difference, and 14 to 20th is the 6 days difference, and the covariance should be the same. So you know, let's go little step by step. You know, once I was presenting to someone, the person asked me that, you know, like, what is the meaning of variance, what is the meaning of mean here when you have only one data point? You know, what you need to understand that we are talking of the stochastic process. A particular realization is just the particular values that a particular stochastic process has taken. In the last video, like which I have presented what is stochastic process, I have explained that even a time series or GDP is nothing but a particular outcome of a stochastic process. Let me explain you these things slightly better so that you could never get confused. When we talk of a stochastic stationary process, the questions like which mean, which variance and covariance we are talking, you know, the mean, covariance and variance we are talking of the stochastic process. So suppose, you know, the series, like, you know, we right now have taken just the three outcome of a particular stochastic process. Suppose, you know, there is a stochastic process which generates random number, and suppose we are talking of millions of random number sequence that got generated. Then the mean of these million value that you could see here, I've shown only three, but you know, in reality what you need to understand, if I had put many, you could have got confused. But if there are many millions of lines like this, the mean of these million line values, you know, you take on 8th June, 10th June, 9th June, 12th June, the mean is supposed to be the same. If the mean is same across time, then that's the first condition of the stochastic process. The second condition, there are millions of values, you know, you can calculate variance of these data points across the mean of the these values that is occurring on 8th June. That is the standard deviation, right? You can take the variance here also, right? On 12th June, you can take variance on 13th June. If the standard deviation or variance of the millions values that occurring on any given day is very much same, so that you're measuring on 8th or 9th or 10th, it's same. That's the second condition of stochastic process, stationary stochastic process. And what is the third condition? The third condition is that, suppose between 4th and 10th, if you're measuring the covariance, you know, the whatever value of covariance you are getting, if you measure it say on 16th and 22nd, which is again 6 days time period, the covariance between 6th and 22nd should be very much same as what you are getting on 4th and 10th, because both are 6 days different. So covariance is actually time independent. Covariance matters only between two time period. The what matters is the lag. You know, it doesn't matter that you are taking on 4th or you are taking on 16th. What matters is how far these data points are. If these are 6 data points and these are also 6 data points, the covariance should be the same. So the three conditions, let me repeat once again. Let me just go back and talk to you once again that what we talked. Its mean is constant over time. So its mean is constant over time. Its variance is constant over time. And the covariance between two time periods depends only on the distance. So it's a 6 period difference and 10 period difference. Between the two, is that just a typo, between the two time period, but not the actual value of the time at which it is taken. So you took on 4th or you took on 10th or you took on 22nd, it doesn't matter. What matters is that how far is the lag, and that's what should decide the covariance. If these three things are matching, you call the series stationary series. So we saw this, like the meaning of the covariance, and we saw that how it is time independent. Now the time is to see a real Excel example. So this time series, you can see it's just a random number, it's generating random number, and one of the properties of Excel is that you hit button, any button again, it generates the whole series once again. Now I have generated 99 random numbers, right? You know, and then I have taken sum here, you can see it's B2 to 100, and then you know I am taking average, which is like, you know, 99, sum of 99 values divided by 99, you have kept on doing, and I have taken variance, I have used the variance formula of these 99 numbers. Now what you need to look at the average. You know, the average is very much, you know, of the 100 data points is very much around 0.5, you know. Even if I generate again, as I told you, like, you know, hit any key again, Excel generates the button, it's again between 0.05, around 0.05, you know. Again if you run it, it's point around 0.5. So the point that I'm trying to say, this series, I have taken a particular example, random number, you know, complete random number, is an example of a stationary time series. What you can see, the mean is constant over time, you know, and the variance, you know, I have taken the variance, you know, generate variance again, right, click on again, it generates. The variance is also very much, you know, hovering around a particular value. So variance is constant over time. And the covariance, I have used the covariance formula. Here the covariance are calculated actually between F2 to B5. So if you see, these are separated out by three data points, 1, 2, 3, 4th data point. You know, this had been 1, this 2, this 3, this 4. So this lag is 4. So now if you look at this, the covariance here. Now second is the covariance between G and C. So essentially again separated by 4 data points. What you can see, the covariance, you know, which I have taken, it's very much same, right? It's just hovering around, like, you know, a particular value. Right now it is 0. So essentially, like, you know, in this series, which is a random series, like, you know, the covariance is also very much hovering around 0. So the covariance, the mean is constant over time, the variance is constant over time, and the covariance between, you know, two different data points here, what you need to understand, that I'm talking of covariance seen between 6th and 2nd. Here I'm talking of covariance between 7th and 3rd. You know, the covariance between two data points are independent, that, you know, on which point I'm measuring. What matters is that how far it is. So till the time I'm talking of 4 data points, the covariance is same. If I talk of 10 data points, the covariance will be different, but you're taking covariance between 10th and 1st, or between 19th, between 20th or 11th, it doesn't matter. What matters is that how far these two data points are. So essentially, coming back to this thing, here the series tends to turn around mean. So essentially, even the series, if series is going here and there, it comes back towards mean. So this kind of process is called mean reversion. The second thing, why the concept of stationary is important. You know, non-stationary series means that mean or variance is changing over time, or the covariance is changing over time. So in that case, you can study it, you can describe a particular series, it can be descriptive, but you can't use for forecasting, because neither you know the mean nor you know the variance. And usually in time series analysis, any forecasting, what you try to do, if a series is non-stationary, you try to make it stationary by taking difference of two terms, by, you know, like reducing a particular equation or whatever. We'll learn a lot in these channel about these in different videos coming in this channel. But essentially what you try to do, you try to make the series by differentiating between two terms, or, you know, reducing a particular equation to make it stationary. And then, you know, stationary series can be forecasted, because mean, variance, and, you know, covariance is like known. And then you try to get back to the original equation. I know this particular term would not have been so, like, you know, clear here, but trust me, you are going to learn about these in the next few videos. Thank you. Thanks for your time. You may subscribe to this video to learn more and get to know about more videos that are going to